Hello everyone. In today's session, let's learn about the credit rating agencies, the origin and the growth of credit rating agencies in India, and also let's learn about institutions which are rating the different securities such as commercial papers, equities, debentures, the mutual fund ratings, the corporate governance ratings, the structure finance ratings, the performance ratings, bank rating, and so on. So let's start. The credit rating agencies assess the creditworthiness of organizations and the different entities. In simple words, these are the agencies which analyze a debtor's ability to repay the debt and also rate their credit risk. All the credit rating agencies in India are regulated by SEBI, the Stock Exchange Board of India, the regulations related to credit rating agencies of 1999. So, as per the SEBI's Act of 1992, which relates to the credit rating agency regulations of 1999, so that covers the complete credit rating agency's governance in India. Now, credit rating is of a recent origin in India, the first institution having a setup in the year 1988. It marks as a major transition from a corporate culture where name matter to abstract grading counts. Also, if you have seen in India, the crediting agencies assess an entity's credit worthiness in general terms or relating to a particular debt or a financial obligations. Now, credit rating helps lenders and the investors to determine the potential risk involved in the lending money to a particular borrowing entity, and also they gauge the entity's repayment ability based on its past credit behavior. Now, Securities and Exchange Board of India Act of 1992 authorizes and regulates all the credit rating agencies in India as per the SEBI regulations of 1999. How this credit rating agencies work? Now, credit rating agencies assign the ratings to an organization or an entity. Now, entities are rated by the credit rating agencies comprised of companies, the state governments, the non-profit organizations, or we call it as an NGOs, countries, securities, the special purpose entities, and also for the local government bodies. The credit rating agencies also take into consideration several factors like the financial statements, the level and the type of the debt. They also consider the lending and the borrowing of history, the ability to repay the debt, and the past and the debt of the entity before rating their credit. Once a credit rating agency rates the entities, it provides additional input to the investors, following which the investors analyze and take a sound investment decision. Now, poor credit rating indicates that the entity is at a higher risk of defaulting. The credit rating that are given to the entities also serve as a benchmark for financial market regulations. If you have considered with the credit ratings which are published by agencies like Moody's, Investors Service and Standards, so we call it as an S&P, will have a detailed analysis of the ratings. Now, there are 7 credit rating agencies in India as per which are authorized as per the SEBI to assess the credit rating in India. Now, which are those 7 institutes? We have CRISIL, we have Acute Ratings and Research, we have ICRA, ICRA, we have Brickwork Ratings India Private Limited, we have CARE and India Rating Research Private Limited, and we have Informatics Valuation and Ratings Private Limited. So these are the 7 institutions which are basically authorized as per SEBI to rate the securities, the corporates, the bank ratings, bank loans, non-profit organizations, and other local corporates in India. Okay, so let's discuss all these institutions one by one. Now, firstly, we'll discuss about CRISIL. What is CRISIL? CRISIL is Credit Rating Information Service of India Limited. Now, it was set up in the year 1987, the oldest credit rating agency of India, and it evaluates the credit worthiness of the commercial entities on the basis of their strength, the market reputations, the market share, and the board of directors. Also, CRISIL undertakes the rating of the mandated instruments, namely like commercial papers, the debentures, deposits, etc. CRISIL also helps the investors to make an informed investment decisions by providing the credit rating for companies, for the organizations, and also for the banks. Now, starting from 2016, CRISIL has also ventured into an infrastructure rating. Now, it has launched the India's first index to benchmark performance of the investment of the foreign portfolio investors, FPI, foreign portfolio investments in the fixed income market in the rupee as well as dollar version in 2018. The company's portfolio also includes the mutual fund ranking. Now, unit linked insurance plans, the ULIP rankings, and CRISIL coalition index, and so on. So that's about CRISIL. Now, other than the CRISIL, second institutions which we have in India is ICRA, ICRA we call it, Investment Information and the Credit Rating Agency of India Limited. Now, ICRA was established in the year 1991 and it is headquartered in Mumbai. The Investment Information and the Credit Rating Agencies of India uses a transparent rating system to assign the comprehensive credit ratings to the corporate. Also, ICRA is known for assigning the corporate governance rating, mutual fund rating, the structured finance rating, the performance rating, and the bank ratings. The company was formerly known as Investment Information and Credit Rating Agencies of India Limited. And before going to public in the year 2007 April, ICRA was a joint venture between the Moody's and several Indian financial sector and banking service organizations. Now, ICRA group currently has four subsidiaries: the consulting and the analytics, the data service and the KPO, ICRA Lanka, and ICRA Nepal. At present, Moody's Investors Service, the international credit rating agency, is ICRA's largest shareholder. Let's learn now about the Credit Analysis and Research Limited. We call it as CARE, Credit Analysis and Research Limited. Now, CARE was launched in the year 1993, and CARE offers credit rating services to the areas such as corporate governance, the debt ratings, the financial sector, the bank loan ratings, the issuer ratings, recovery ratings, and the infrastructure ratings, long-term ratings, and the short-term debt instruments ratings as well. Now, company also offers the ratings for the IPOs, the initial public offerings, the real estates, the renewable energy service companies like RESCO, and the financial assessment of shipyards, energy service companies like ESCO, E-S-C-O, ESCO, grades the various scores of educational institutions. CARE Ratings has also ventured into valuation of services and offers the valuation of equities, the debt instruments, the marked linked debentures, etc. Moreover, the CARE has launched a new international credit rating agency, ARC Ratings, by teaming up with four partners from the South Africa, Brazil, Portugal, and Malaysia. Now, ARC Ratings has commenced operations and completed the sovereign ratings of the countries, including India. Let's learn now about the fourth credit rating agency, which is authorized by SEBI to rate the different types of securities and the corporate entities. Now that is brickwork rating. We call it as BWR, brickwork ratings. Now brickwork rating was established in the year 2007 and it is promoted by the Canara Bank. It offers the ratings for bank loans, for SMEs, for the corporate governance ratings, municipal corporations, capital market instruments, and the financial institutions. It also grades the NGOs and tourism, IPOs, real estate investments, hospitals, educational institutes, mutual fund institutions, and MNRE. Now, Brickwork Rating is recognized as an External Credit Assessment Agency, ECAI, by the Reserve Bank of India to carry out the credit rating in India. Now, other than the brickwork rating, so I said we discussed now about CRISIL, we discussed about ICRA, we discussed about CARE, and we discussed also about the brickwork ratings. Other than these four institutes, we also have other three institutions which are rating the securities in India. The fifth one here is India Rating Research Private Limited. Now, India Rating is a wholly owned subsidiary of Fitch Group. It offers the credit ratings for insurance companies, for the banks, for the corporate issuers, and the project finance and the financial institutions. The finance and the leasing companies are also being rated by the India Rating Research Private Limited. They also help in managed funds and urban local bodies ratings. In addition to the SEBI, the India Rating Research Private Limited is also being recognized by the Reserve Bank of India and the National Housing Bank. Now, the sixth credit rating agency which we are going to discuss now is about Acute Ratings and Research Limited. Now, Acute Rating and Research Limited is a full service agency registered with the SEBI. The company received RBI accreditation as an External Credit Assessment Institutions, ECAI, for bank loan ratings under Basel II norms in the year 2012. Since then, it has assigned more than 8,300 credit ratings to various securities, debt instruments, and the banking facilities of the entities spread across the country and for the section of the industries. It has registered its head office in BKC, Mumbai. The last credit rating agency which we are going to discuss is about Infometrics Valuation and the Private Limited. Infometrics Valuation and Ratings Private Limited is an credit rating agency which is RBI accredited credit rating agency and also SEBI registered credit rating agency. Now, Informatic Valuation and the Ratings Private Limited is established by the eminent financial professionals, and it now runs under the leadership of Mr. Vipin Malik. Now, Credit Bureau strives to offer an unbiased and detailed analysis and evaluation of the credit worthiness to the non-bank financial companies, banks, corporates, and the small and the medium scale units. It has their ratings and the grading system which determines the credit worthiness of any of these organizations. Informatics also helps in reducing any kind of information asymmetry among the investors and the lenders. Informatics Valuation Limited also keeps transparency as its core value. The Credit Bureau makes sure to deliver the comprehensive and accurate reports and the records of all their clients. Now, these are the institutions which are rating the credit, different securities and the corporate entities in India. Now, a few examples, if we'll have to quote related to the credit rating agencies and their ratings recently. Now, India Ratings and the Research has rated JK Papers at A+ with an outlook to be stable. Also, CARE has reaffirmed the credit rating of an SL PropBank recently. Whereas it has rated CARE AA for a short-term bank facilities, crediting of CARE A+ for the short-term and long-term bank facilities, crediting of CARE A1, CARE AA for non-convertible debentures, NCDs of the company, etc. Now, CRA has also, crediting agencies has downgraded Divan Housing Finance Corporation, DHFL, purchaser payers and pass-through certificates, we call it as in PTCs, which is issued under the 6 mortgage loan securitization transactions, which was worth ₹6,630 crores. The latest slash in the rating comes with a couple of days after CRISIL rating agencies has downgraded housing finance company's commercial paper worth ₹850 crores. The rating of the PTCs have been revised by A- from BBB by an ICRA credit rating agencies. Now, these are the few examples which I can quote presently as per this crediting agency which are rating the institutions and the securities. So, that's it for the day. Thank you.